This is Brandon Lee, a Chinese American who married a Filipina and raised a family in the Philippines' Ifugao province after an exposure trip as a student at San Francisco State University. His families and friends say Brandon is now a human rights worker for the Ifugao peasant movement. But these posters, found throughout the Ifugao province and on online social media sites, claims he is a member of the New People's Army and should be regarded as an enemy of the state. Through contact with family and friends in the U.S., Brandon says he is currently safe, but fears for his well-being.
I'm very concerned about that because it is placing my son's life in danger along with his colleagues.
Brandon's family, his former teacher at San Francisco State University and current supervisor, Eric Marr, and Filipino-American activists met with Deputy Consul General Jaime Escalon and other members of the Philippine Consulate to demand an investigation into the alleged political vilification and harassment of Brandon and other human rights workers. They say the Philippine government's counterinsurgency policy called Oplan Bayanihan intentionally associates human rights workers like Brandon with the rebel group to justify illegal arrests.
We're really trying to put pressure on what's happening in the Philippines with the vilification campaigns on not only human rights defenders, but indigenous peoples activists. We don't want the same thing to happen to Brandon that happened to Melissa Rojas.
In 2009, Rojas, a Filipino-American activist, was allegedly abducted and held prisoner by whom she believes were members of the Philippine military. Deputy Consul General Escalon listened to Brandon's supporters and reassured them that the Philippine government upholds human rights laws and will pass along this information to proper agencies in the Philippines to ensure Brandon's safety. Brandon's mother will be flying out to the Philippines by the end of the month to visit him and his family.
During the meeting, we in fact even suggested a meeting between the mother of Brandon and the regional police office based in Benguet, just to introduce and for her to personally convey also her concerns to authorities in the Philippines.
They acknowledged what I said, and they did state that they would be contacting Philippine officials in Washington, D.C., and also in the Philippines. So I think this is all a good beginning.
The activists say they will continue to pressure the consulate in following through with an investigation to end the harassment and threats of human rights workers in the Cordillera region. Romel Quinclara, ABS-CBN News, San Francisco.